Me and my wife got married in 2014. We've been together since 2008. This year, it'll be 14 years, which is crazy when I actually say it out loud. But yeah, as soon as we got married, we wanted kids, and we struggled for a long time. But you know, I think the truth is, shit just happens. My name's Noodle, and I'm from Northwest London. I got that nickname from my dad. He used to call me Nicky Nacky Noodle, and it just became Noodle for short. I set up a digital agency in 2009, and then in 2014, I partnered with two other people to optimize the business's performance and gain some fantastic new blue chip clients. And now, thinking about it, I'm sitting in the garden right now, and I'm absolutely blessed in as much as we have a great business and we have some incredible clients. I must have first heard about Bitcoin at the end of 2012. I was in the gym chatting to this guy that I got on well with. He was like, "Have you ever heard of it?" And it's funny because he was trying to explain the Silk Road thing to me, which was on the dark web. We went out, but it was normally on a Friday night. On a Saturday night, we'd be at someone's house smoking weed and chilling. So anyway, my friend told me we could experiment with it, and I thought, let's do it. I mean, genuinely, Bitcoin opened my eyes to not just the financial world, but so much more. I was reading books, watching YouTube videos, it was non-stop. I couldn't soak up enough information quickly enough. It was kind of almost hovering between a passion and an addiction. I felt like I couldn't hoover up enough information in Bitcoin. I read about how the Federal Reserve worked, and then read about how fractional reserve banking worked, and currency debasement, and this and that and the other. My wife said to me that with some of our wedding money, she wants to buy Bitcoin. And I remember it, something about it. It was around £400, not dollars, but pounds. And who would have known that Bitcoin would then go on to effectively fund our IVF treatment, which is not cheap. Female body clocks, you simply can't afford to muck around. We struggled for a long, long time to have kids, believe me. We've never really liked the stigma around IVF, which means we actually prefer to talk about it than kind of keep it sort of hush-hush the whole time. Anyway, I thought, you know what, fuck it. I said to my wife, we're sitting on a decent amount of Bitcoin, let's do this. It's one or the other. And being honest, I probably would have got a loan out if I didn't have Bitcoin, because to me, family is important, and I would have thrown anything and everything at it in order to try and make it work. The cost behind IVF is astronomical. Most people can't afford it, or they go into debt to be able to afford it. And some people may have said, oh, well, you know, you shouldn't have sold your Bitcoin, you should have got a loan. But I wasn't prepared to be that pig-headed about it. I wanted to get on with things. I didn't want to have to worry about getting approved for loans or financing or whatnot. I can't remember how many Bitcoin I used in the end. With IVF, it's not like you go through this whole process and at the end you're lumped with a big fat invoice. You're paying the whole time, so I was just selling as and when I needed money to fund each step in that IVF process. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. When I had the Bitcoin there, and ultimately there was a kind of thought, I was, you know, thinking that this is going to be our little Bitcoin baby, and it was all worth it in the end. And it was two rounds with our first child, and our second child was just the one round. Without Bitcoin, we would never have been able to do this, and who knows if I'd have been able to get a personal loan for several tens of thousands of pounds.